maybe a little one.
Hello. Yes. Yeah. Hello. I thought yes. Yes. Hello. I'd like to make a complaint about an intro I ordered from your company. Pottery podcast. Yeah. Okay. So essentially, like when we got it, we were very excited to get it. By the way, like such a big service behind it. But when we got it, it just appeared to be the sound of a whip, and then the fading whinnying of a horse. No, but that's in no way representative of our show whatsoever. Well, I mean, I don't care if there's a targeted style matching algorithm, because like in the background, apart from the whipping and the horse, there appears to be the sound of two children dying of dysentery. Well, no, we'd like our money back, ideally. Well, why? Well, fuck off. No, give us. I tell you what, you've got a 2-star Yelp review coming. Okay, fine. 3-star.
Did you get Red Dead instead of the podcast?
No, I didn't.
No. All right. Since you never gave a damn in the first place, maybe it's time you had the tables turned, because the interest of all involved has got the problem solved and the verdict says guilty. And welcome to the Bot Topic podcast.
Oh,
I am the Great Big Mouth.
Look at him! Hark at him!
It's almost like I was listening to Slipknot's first album on the way home. welcome to the Bot Topic podcast. I am your host, Tom, and with me I have two other hosts. We have Captain Sickbeard. Dom, you're right, Dom.
All right. About 8,000 Americans are injured by musical instruments yearly.
Be prepared for more facts this evening.
Facts!
And Taryn.
Allegedly.
Allegedly, Taryn.
Allegedly, Taryn.
Pending the super injunction.
Well, I mean, depending on the sponsors, right, okay, you know, it's, I might need to go through a bit of a thing. But, you know, for now, we can do with allegedly, Taryn. Or allegedly does, if you're feeling fruity.
On this podcast, we feel fruity whilst pulling out topics from the host pot, the community-submitted topic pot, and talking bullshit for about 2 hours whilst drinking whiskey.
Yeah,
and I bought the whiskey tonight, and it is, I've forgotten already, Bowmore 12-year-old single Islay? Yeah, single Islay malt.
Ooh.
So
it's got to be a little smoky.
Absolutely. Right. Oh, almost.
Oh, yeah.
Just tease it a little bit.
Oh, that's good. Oh, that's a fucking stone good in that.
See, I made the mistake of buying 4 beers and a bottle of whiskey because I thought, oh, there's lots of people coming to the podcast tonight.
No.
So, Taryn, let's get on this. Because Dom ain't drinking.
Yep.
Shit.
I work in a school.
I work in a pub. I'm already half cut before I get home.
It's been a while since I've had a Bowmore.
Oh, it was like 13 quid off. Yeah, the fucking judgmental attitude I got in Lewisham Tesco today.
Really?
She was sweet enough. She was just honest mistake. But so no longer can you pick up bottles of whiskey that are supposed to be in boxes from the shelf. They're just empty boxes. And you have to go to customer service to get the bottle.
Oh, really?
They've obviously had a spate of theft or something.
Right, yeah.
Like, even to the point where the cupboard they keep all the booze in has this sign saying, lockdown, no employee bags in here, which means they're suspecting employees are nicking the fucking things.
Oh, please tell me there's also, like, a sentry gun as well.
Yeah. Fucking, like, Road 209 or whatever it is from...
Ed 209,
yes. Robocop. So... yeah, took it over to the customer service desk and was just like, oh, yeah, can I get this microwave beef lasagna, four cans of your finest cheap hobgoblin, and this bottle of Bowmore, which was £13 off. So it was £27. I thought, bargain. She went out, got it, scanned it, went, you do know that's £27, right? Yep. She went, oh, okay. Like, now I'm a bit of a road man, you know, but boyo.
Oh, man, that is, that's fantastic.
Do I look that sketch?
No. No, I think it's probably just because you're pairing it with like a cheap beef lasagna and a four pack of hobgoblin.
I realised the irony. So, yeah. Anyway, what else has everyone been up to?
College.
Yes, of course you have been.
Power hammers.
Power hammer. Is that your new nickname?
Power hammers. No, it's the tool. It's an enigmatic hammer that has a 75 kilogram hammerhead punch. Sorry. And then sort of just hammers at 120 strokes a minute.
Ladies.
Can move metal like anything. As long as it's hot.
It's always hot with you, Tom. Yeah. That is good scotch. Sorry. Anyway.
Yeah, that's basically just been at college and then building some stuff for prison show.
Oh, for a show in a prison?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I believe you mentioned it at some point, yeah.
Opera
yeah.
in prison.
Have you done it before?
I worked on it last year.
Yeah.
And then I got asked to build some stuff for this year.
Cool.
This led to my boss, because he's going inside for the show. But he was just like, we're just chatting about, I'll see you when I get out. And he's just like, you get out most days. He's like, yeah, I know. But it's just funny. You just confuse people when you say you're working in a prison. And you get out at the end.
Oh, that sounds cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Right.
Anything else?
Not really.
No, not really. Okay, cool. Well, there's a whole bunch of house shit. I've learned how to reasonably effectively strip wallpaper, which is
better than I did.
It's pretty fucking satisfying once you get into it. So there was that. Actually, talking about you coming over and helping with the wallpaper.
Don't say I helped with the wallpaper. I came over drunk and scraped a corner for a bit.
Yeah, it was the day after, the very day after that, I had, it was a very bad day, Thomas.
Was it hungover day?
Obviously you and Seal had been over.
Yeah.
And things had gotten messy until about 2 o'clock.
Yep.
But it was all right because we knew, like, we weren't expecting anyone until like 9:30. There was going to be a carpet laid in the bedroom. They were supposed to turn up between 10 and 1. I get woken up by a phone call at like 8:15. So this is the very first thing that's happened to me today. He's like, oh, yeah, all right, mate. I just wanted to make sure that you're in. We're about to come over. What? Who? Why? What? Why? Who's coming where? It's like, oh, we've got the carpet. Well, no, it's not supposed to be coming at 10 till 1. Well, we got it on a piece of paper. It's AM, emergency, dude, quick. And as we're here, we thought we'd grab it and we're already on our way over. We'll be there in 15 minutes. Oh, at which point, Heather's going, oh, no, no, Dad, don't let him come over. He needs to do the things first. And but just vaguely trying to hold it together. It's like, fuck it. I don't know. We'll make it work. And then hung up. So the first, like, got to jump out of bed, fuck the bed off into the next room. The third thing I then have to do with my day is attack the carpet that's there with a fucking Stanley blade and tear that up.
Oh, fuck, you had to rip it out yourself as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, shit, son. Was it just your carpet in your room?
It was, yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, okay.
And then the whole thing was just a fucking nightmare from start to finish. Like, Jeff turned up shortly before the carpet man. He tried to do the thing he wanted to do before the carpet man turned up, and the carpet guys were just like, well, we're going to lay this carpet now. And like, Jeff was like, okay, fine, just give me a sec, we'll put everything back down. I was like, okay, just do it properly, lay it out. And then, like, about half hour later, I'm still having breakfast at this point, very slowly. You must understand.
Very concerned look on your face as you're trying to shovel nutrients in.
At this point, I've been left utterly alone. Like, Jeff's gone and driven Heather off to work, and the carpet dude comes down and says, all right, cool, we're all done. And I was like, what? That was 20 minutes? Like, yeah, it doesn't take long. I'm like, oh, okay. Should we go up and have a look? And I sort of went up and had a look. I sort of walked in, and so my first thought was, yes. There was new carpet.
There we go.
I have no fucking idea what to look for in carpet. No. I was like, yeah, okay, fine.
Did they put it on the wall? No. Okay, that's fine.
Is it upside down?
Yeah.
So I went down, signed off a thing, gave him the money that was due for thing, job done. And then Jeff turns up and like I've still not quite finished breakfast. And,
oh, you're like, so welcome for this and, hangover.
And then we're upstairs, and Jeff is telling me everything that's wrong with that with the carpet, and he's like, "Oh, I need to do this, but look at this, it's all over here." And I'm not equipped for this. This is just no. This is too far away from
you're a child.
As he's telling, no, it'd be fine under other circumstances. Had they turned up when it doesn't matter. I'm not going to get into it. But Jeff is explaining this to me. He's like, do you know what? I'm bailing on this is what I'm doing. So as he's telling me things, I'm literally putting my headphones out of my pocket, very slowly putting them in my ear. And once they're in, I sort of plug it into my phone and before I press play, and I go, right, yeah, okay, cool. Well, I see you've already got the carpet up. You're going to do the, I'm going to go strip some wallpaper. Because that's at least is fucking safe.
Yeah.
But I mean, we've, all right, we got that all sorted. The other thing that's happened is I accidentally walked into the start. accidentally walked into the start of a horror story. So we're down in Hastings over the weekend for Darren's unbirthday.
I'm already quaking in my boots. You're in Hastings,
and so before we go to the pub, Heather and I just have a quick look around George Street, which is like the big kind of shoppy street in Old Town. And we walk into one of the hippie shops, and like in there, there's a bunch of hippie-ish stuff. And then there's a cafe in the back. And then in the back, there's just a collection of the other shit that's not quite good enough to put up front. And the very first thing we came across was this like basket of broken mannequin arms. And like they're fucking like they're hand turned hardwoods. Beautiful things, broken. Yeah. So as we're looking through them, and this has never happened to me, so we're looking through it, just rifling through, it's like, we found one with the index and middle finger missing. So you've just got like this thumb that's kind of coming in at a weird angle, and then you've got these, the two fingers on the end.
Yeah, okay.
And we're sort of looking, it's like, that one's really cool. But it's all carried on walking around, so fucked off, went to the pub. And I was just thinking about that fucking mannequin arm, man. And I just kept thinking. I couldn't stop thinking about it. Right, after, I think...
Okay, my mind's going really depraved, so please take this to the punch.
No, it's nothing depraved. I was just thinking about it. It was a really cool mannequin arm. I want that in my life. I don't know why. I was just like, can have it erupting from the ceiling in the downstairs of our house. Or I just kept thinking about it. And at one point... I was just like, do you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to go buy a mannequin arm. I'm going to go buy a broken mannequin arm. And, Heather was encouraging because she never gets to see, she never sees
this.
Yeah,
no. Like, you don't splurge on dumb shit.
In recent times, I've recently revealed to her that when we go out shopping, I walk around stony faced and I react to very little because the second I show the slightest interest in anything, that's it. As far as Heather's concerned, I've always wanted it, and we've basically already bought it.
Yeah.
So I kind of tend to keep
shut
that shit
down.
In. I was somewhat hungover this morning, that morning.
Shocker.
And it was just like, yeah, all right, fine, I'm going to go do it. And I sort of walked into the shop and waited for the woman there to stop serving. And she's like, I'm sorry, I know this might be a bit of a weird question, but are those broken mannequin arms for sale? And she was just like, yeah, no, it's not a weird question at all. Yeah, absolutely. They're beautiful, aren't they? Like, which one were you thinking? Like, if there's one finger, if it's got one finger, like, maybe sell it to you for 45. And already I'm going, okay, thank fuck. That's far too much. And she's like, a complete arm, they go for like between 80 and 90 quid.
What?
Yeah, for real.
Yeah. Fucking just do a clock. Plaster cast of your
own fucking
arm.
No, because they're hand-turned. They're the ones that you see in like...
Oh, I see. Okay, yeah.
Hawksmoor.
Okay.
Like, normally they've got a proper plaster body covered in fabric.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
So we go and have a look at it. And she goes, was there one in particular? He's like, yes, there was one in particular, actually. Let me show you the one in particular. I'm rifling through, and there I find her again. Just the thumb and the two fingers.
I like the
on
fact
the
you've assigned a gender to this hand.
Oh, wait. I was sort of looking at that one, and she's like, I mean, like I said, they're 45. And I'm like, I mean, it is beautiful. I don't know why I keep thinking about it, but 45, that's just too silly. At which point she just goes, all right, 30, but that's as low as I could possibly go. Like, I was like, ah, oh, fuck. She somehow found the magic number. 30 would be as high as I would go, apparently. But I almost walked out the shop without buying it. I got to the door, went, no. Went back, grabbed the armor. Okay, I'll have it. And as she's, taking my money and getting a bag for it, I just said, can you just, like, I know it's a weird thing, but can you just promise me it's not cursed? At which point, she laughed. Anyway, so I turn up back at the pub where
Wait. Was it like a normal laugh or like a mild cackle that you may have brushed aside?
I have no idea. I don't think it was a cackle. You can never tell with hippies, though.
acid damage, fox. Yeah.
But I go back to the pub, and more people have arrived, and including our mate Laura. I won't say her second name. I haven't seen her in like a decade.
Yeah.
But I turn up, and I just she hasn't seen me in like a decade. I just have to go, look what I bought, and produce this broken mannequin arm, and yeah, it sort of came out a couple of times. It's featured in a couple of photos. And then the next morning, I decided to name it. And it's called Prudence now. Her name is Prudence. And then I started...
Is there a reasoning? Is there like some clever pun missing?
No, I was just... I mean, I started on Credence, and Credence didn't quite fit. And then I realised that actually Prudence is the one.
Okay.
So when we... Rather than being able to have a hangover in the comfort of a bed... I'd made the mistake of letting Heather and Alex spend too much time together the previous night, and they decided, let's go to a castle tomorrow, fuckers.
Yeah.
So we have to get up and pack all our shit, and as we've packed everything up, it's like, I just went, do you know what? I'd pulled I pulled Prudence out of her bag, I'd put it in the back seat. So I think Prudence would probably enjoy the drive.
Fucking hell.
It's just sort of like, it's going to be sort of like sat in the room and just Prudence is just on the wall, and you're just like, no, Prudence, I can't do it.
Have either of you seen the like Netflix film The Boy?
No, yes. No, I haven't.
Right, yeah, that's what I'm seeing in my head.
So, we get to Bodiam Castle, we have a lovely day there, and then when we're set down, just before we go, everyone fucks off to get like a tea and some cake. I fuck off and get Prudence. So I bring Prudence to the table and... I'm noticing I'm beginning to behave a little weirdly around Prudence, and I'm finding that entertaining for myself.
Yeah, of course you are.
But I'm sort of playing it through in my head. It's like, okay, I mean, how far can I push this? Anyway, like, Prudence got to drive in the back seat again on the way home, and she was the first thing in the house, and I said as I opened the door, I was like, welcome to your new home, Prudence, then put her down in the down, and just before I left to go to Kells, Heather was getting something from the car, and I grabbed Prudence and I moved her upstairs into our room, just more or less unconsciously. And then I went and watched some, went over to Kells and watched some shit and came back. And as I was sort of on my way back, I was kind of adding all this up. It's like, this is like the beginning of a fucking horror story. I wonder how much I could push this. And I was thinking, like, if Heather mentions, like, Prudence, or do I walk in and say, oh, did you put Prudence there? Do I start doing that stuff?
No,
and
no.
then I realized that actually that could quite easily go beyond, because I was so, I found myself so ready to commit to it.
Oh, yeah, like, yeah. Of course you did.
Do you know what? I think this could quite quickly go beyond a prank and become like full blown gaslighting.
Yeah. No,
so let's put the stoppers on it there. And the way I decided to put the stoppers on it was to tell Heather all of this. And the thing she picked up on, so she hadn't even thought about how potentially creepy it was.
Yeah.
But like after I was done telling her, she said to me, "It's like you asked the shop attendant if it was cursed." Oh no! And she's like, "Oh, I'm not. I don't know if I want it up here anymore. Like, don't you dare move it in the night. I swear to God."
Okay, so secretly you move it into a bag once every 5 years. Just like play the long game, okay? When she's got a big important meeting or something, or she needs to go on a long journey across the planet, just sneak it in there. Like, you go through the airport scanner and you see it on the x-ray.
if you're willing to risk prudence, just have it clinging on to the back window wipe.
I was, all this was just kind of like going through my mind. It's like all the different things I could do to fuck with Heather. And then the thing I was watching over at Kells was The Haunting of Hill House, which is pretty creepy. And it's just, I was walking back in the dark all by myself, and I was thinking, like, I mean, this would almost creep me out. And then I remember that, like, I mean, Heather's getting creeped out watching the new series of Sabrina. Like, if I really commit to this, I'm going to break her.
Oh, fuck, sorry, that reminds me. I almost broke a fully grown South African dude the other day.
Really?
Yeah. So, one of the chefs at work, he just works weekends. He's a ridiculously talented chef. Jono. He's in the kitchen. He's prepping up for Sunday, and I'm the first person in after him. So I come into the kitchen, just open the door, and just go, "Morning, Jono, you're right, mate." At which point he goes, "Fucking up!" Absolutely scared to shitless. And I'm like, "Shit, sorry, dude, I didn't mean to scare you, you're right." He went, "Yeah, man, no, I was at the coffee machine earlier, and he doesn't know how to turn on the lights in the restaurant, and it's like 8 o'clock in the morning, it's like October, so it's a little bit dark, but it's like twilighty almost outside, dusk." Yeah. And he looks, there are many stories about my pub being haunted, and he looks up to the back of the pub and he sees in front of the fireplace, for what he says was like a millisecond, a girl dressed in a Victorian long dress with a big hoop skirt sort of thing. Just for a millisecond. And it was enough to freak him out at that point. So for the rest of the day,
Tom went home, got his Victorian schoolgirl outfit with the hoop dress.
I'm going to play the long game with him.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Mate, the first, like, apparently, the first, like, give it a name. That's always the start.
What is the spookiest haunted girl name?
Prudence.
Prudence is pretty high up. Can I borrow your hand? I'll just reach it through the door and just rest it on his shoulder while he's prepping shit in the morning.
No, I mean, Prudence quite likes my house now.
Prudence has told me she doesn't want to leave. Cool.
So, Tara, if you ever wanted Prudence to move, I think I could probably help you out there. Get the last three fingers twitching with some servos.
Do you know what? I think what I landed on is like, do you know what? I'm already halfway into a horror story. I should probably just write this at some point.
About a hippie who buys a mannequin arm that...
Well, no, you basically need to write yourself a novella where you are getting freaked out by having this hand in your possession.
Yeah.
You've got to come up with some really dark shit.
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Arguing with a hand.
Right, anything else?
Like Daredevil.
Who said that? What?
What?
Shh, Prudence.
Yeah, what have you been up to, Tom?
Well, today, actually, like literally a few minutes ago, I realised that, one, we are beating Adam Buxton by like 12 podcasts.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's on like 85 and we're on 97, motherfucker. So, amateur.
Fucking
amateur.
Just go to show, it is quantity, not quality.
It is exactly. The long game.
It is the long game. Also, we appear to always record on November the 16th, 6th.
Oh, do we?
Yeah. So, remember the podcast where we drank tequila?
No.
No, neither do I. And that's the problem.
Foreshadowing.
That was one. And also, Christakis' first podcast was on November the 6th. And there was another recording in the first year on November the 6th. It's really weird. So, this needs to be an annual thing. No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't. Also, I had a sexident.
Mm-mm.
A sex in what? Accident.
What have you broken?
Okay.
Or who have you broken?
So you know how we promised we need to be candid about this shit?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So let me tell you a little story. So me and my lady friend, completely exhausted, pass out, neither of us getting to the finishing post.
Yeah.
Fair enough. I've been using condoms for the first time in about, it's got to be approaching a decade.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah, probably.
Well, I hope you're going rolling with those Pleasure Max, man.
I'm rolling with whatever's cheapest at the moment until everything gets tested. Hey! So pass out with said banger on my banger. Wake up halfway through the night, realise I really need to pee. Go to pee.
Oh,
motherfucker. Oh, no, there was a moment of like dazed glory where I went, am I peeing on the floor? Where the fuck is it going? It's not going in the toilet. When I look down, I've got like a fucking water balloon on the end of my dick.
Oh, I was hoping for something like approaching Mentos and Diet Coke.
It got to the point where I was like, if I'd waited a millisecond longer, that thing would have shot off and exploded across the room. Oh, fucking, at which point... The subtle movement of trying to remove a banger from your ween full of pee and then dip it into a toilet.
Now, that's something I can honestly say I've never experienced before.
Okay, it's called a posh wee. Maybe you should try it. The fact that I then walked into the bedroom, woke her up and went, okay, I've got to tell you this.
it's not called a posh wee, it's called an Archimedes banger, right?
Boom, boom, well done. I honestly think that's about it, really. Oh, cool. I've been listening to Rikard's new album.
So have I.
So go listen to Seventh Dimension. I'm going to use that as my plug for the outro, but Seventh Dimension have just released a new album. What's it called? I can't remember.
The Corrupted Lullaby.
There we go.
I listened to it, I streamed it a couple of times and then had to buy it. Cause I've been massively, massively impressed.
Yeah. Like, I need to buy a physical copy.
Yeah. I've listened to their stuff before and just gone, oh yeah, no, that's pretty cool. But just like never really went back to it. I was never drawn back to it.
All right, don't beat the fuck out of our OG fucking foreign listeners.
But then listening to this, it was just like, yeah, I mean, I listened to it through twice completely. It's like, right, no, okay, I am going to listen to this more, and bought it, and have since listened to it through several more times. It's like really cool to see like everything that they've like. I've gone back to listen to other bits and pieces, they started playing with this idea here or that idea there, and then it's all just coming together, and it's like, yeah, that was really cool.
And that's coming from someone who doesn't listen to lyrics as well, so the lyrics are very very
so this is one of my favorite things about Bandcamp.
Okay, they got the lyrics
there.
You can actually read the poetry whilst
absolutely okay. I mean, for me, I'm reading it like a story rather than a poem, because fuck poetry. Writing in is dutty butty.
But you had to make those two words rhyme. Fair enough.
That's not poetry. That's just right. Wordalism.
And there we have the title of the podcast.
The disgusting look on Tom's face with that.
That was a grimace. Right, shall we get on with this ting?
Mm. Yeah.
Straight up, right to ting.
Let's do it.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I did forget one thing.
No, that's the thing with Dom. Every time he stretches back, I can still hear him perfectly through the mic. I don't know what it is.
No. I'm a dirty, dirty sellout, and I've had a sponsorship deal with the phone.
Oh, of course, your sick ass fucking phone.
This one.
Go on, tell the endurers about it.
I've got an S61 by Caterpillar. It's got thermal imaging. It's got an F.
Well, okay, that's enough. They're sponsoring you, not us.
Fuck that! I want one.
It does look pretty.
I want to
cool.
have sex with your phone. It has a warning label.
It's got a built-in class 2.
No,
laser.
I mean, no. I want to use its IR camera filming me while I have sex, just so I can see.
to see how cold it really is. Cold and lifeless.
Oh, it's the second I come, just all the heat floods out of my body. And weirdly, you can see my skull smiling at you.
Jesus Christ. Is that what, like a Mortal Kombat fatality? Bullbreaker.
You know, I was more thinking, you feel me, you just look in the background, there's just this like cold spot of a hand.
Sorry, bone breaker, I hardly know. Anyway.
Yeah, that was the only other thing I've suddenly remembered.
That phone is cool.
Yeah, I like it.
How many followers have you got on your Instagram?
250-something.
Ah, nice.
It keeps fluctuating.
So it's probably made way more than us.
There's more followers than we've got on the Facebook page, for sure.
Who cares?
Facebook is dead.
Probably. Oh, yeah, fucking Zuck. Zuck the Cuck is on his way out, isn't he?
Is he?
Apparently so. The shareholders were voting to try and remove him from Facebook.
The batteries are running low.
Oh, no. Oh, that, I mean, that, if it's the shareholders trying to get rid of Zuck, that sounds potentially worse than just letting Zuck carry on doing what Zuck does.
Basically, they've just gone...
an alien.
They've just gone, well, no, we want to sell all the information we want. And Zuck's going like, we can't be evil. It's like, Red, you're out.
We can't be evil. We just had a government injunction in what we're doing. Anyway, this is not a topic. However,
topics.
We should probably start the topic since we're like half an hour in already.
Yeah, let's fucking do it.
All right.
Yeah,
I picked last time.
Dom, there you go, mate.
Okay.
One from the host, one from the hot pot, one from us. Dig deep and deep, dig true. Okay, I'm going to slow down on the booze. Clearly, I can't talk.
Dig doop and droop
doop. Dig doo and droop doo the voodoo that you do so well.
From me.
Hey, you're right, Dom.
Yep.
What we got?
You're sent back in time, but your consciousness is transferred into that of a baby. How do you cope?
I like this topic.
I mean, I just, it'd be...
Essentially, you are Stewie Griffin.
No, essentially, you're the fucking dude from the one Metallica video. You're Lockett-in syndrome.
Only for a short amount of time.
A few years, enough to go into clinically insane. A couple years.
I mean, I'd probably, if I can't make myself talk early, I would say cognitively, I'm still all there.
Yeah, you're okay, still cool. Fully aware of...
So either you try and accelerate your kind of physical development process, at least
by
start
getting massive gains. Yeah, just
absolutely. giving that mummy titty twisters. if I can't do that, then I know it's basically I'm going to spend the first couple of years really like nailing transcendental meditation until the point that I'm able to walk. And have a fucking drink, and then I'll enjoy like being a cheap date again.
Quick, darling, quick, darling. Young Taran's gonna say his first words. What whiskey?
It's only so like out of your mind you can get on cowpole, I guess. Isn't it? I don't know. Like if
Chura. no, mummy, Chura. Mummy, Jura. Mummy, Jura superstition, bitch. Now!
Jura superstition. Sorry, every time I hear that. I think if my consciousness was in a baby, I'd just make sure that I had to go to shit every time someone removed my nappy. Just be an absolute dick with it. Just because you can.
Let a little bit out so they go, oh, it's time to change Tom.
He's smelly. Oh, you smelly little boy. Okay, wee in his eye.
Yeah, no, this is the thing. If you're fully cognizant, you could just cry and cry and cry until they change you. You don't even need to pre-seal yourself. Just cry and cry and cry until they free you up and then they go, ha ha, motherfucker.
What if you made it really abstract? Maybe it was like baby version of I Spy With My Little Eye. There's something in the room you want and you cry until you get that one particular thing.
Why does he still want the whiskey? I don't understand, Taran. You're too young.
Why does he want a chalkboard marker?
Mama, Daddy, butt plug. What? Hang on, how far back have we gone? Would that make any sense to them whatsoever?
We've gone back to the 87, essentially.
Oh, to 87. Oh, what? Back in my own body?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't realize we traveled back. Yes, no, you're right. You did say that. Okay.
Yeah, I missed that bit. Oh, God. Oh, man. Oh, I'd probably spend the entire time cursing my shit memory because... Like I wouldn't remember where like what bets to make when and like what stocks to buy.
To be fair, for us, we would just get to experience the '80s a bit more. It might be quite interesting, although from a fucking pram, so maybe not. That you can't get much coke in a pram.
I don't know. One of those old '80s like perambula ones. You could.
Yeah, I suppose. He's smuggle some at least.
Mound it up over the baby.
Yeah, I don't know. I think try and hold on to my fucking mind.
I thought you were going to say my dick.
Hold on to my dick.
I just remembered another thing. I found a bottle of Pacino underneath my grandmother's stairs.
Uh-oh. Oh, hell yeah. I forgot your surname was Kelly.
Yep. And four bottles of Remy Martin.
Romain Martin.
Sorry, Bowmore. It's good.
It's a good fucking whiskey.
It is. Good. It is thoroughly drinkable.
Yeah, I've got to slow down.
I don't know. I mean, what else would I do? I'd probably be even more of a terrorist. Like, obviously, I'd have to wait till I was like 4 or 5 or whatever, but I'd be even more of a terrorist, my sister.
Oh, no, you could plot at this point. It wouldn't just be like vindictive or reactionary violence. You could plot some violence.
If you could master the pratfall, you could basically wait till she's at the top of the stairs with you, throw yourself down, and then blame her.
I mean, flowers for me down the stairs
again.
As an interesting social experiment, like try and operate some sort of matter of prescience, and so like when it came to, so what I would have been, maybe 8, 9 at the time when Freya was like looking for a secondary school, and just every now and then just say something weird like, Beaverwood will be the death of her mother. Can I have some Marmite, please?
I'm just trying to think of ways to freak out my parents. I think probably just sit there in like the lotus position whilst listening to the Devin Townsend Project. Just really freak them out. Oh no, I've got to go back to 85.
Yeah, you do, unfortunately.
At least I don't have to listen to Devin Townsend Project.
But you'd understand how to work record players and tape players and everything, so that every time...
Yeah, but it'd be my parents' record, so literally all I could listen to is Bob Dylan. That's the only thing I like from my parents.
Every time they put on Queen, you just get up, toddle over, and just take it off.
Yeah, just smash it over my diaper.
And just go, he's a bad man!
Homophobic. Right.
Yeah, cool. Should we have one from Il Comunità?
Why not?
Pass over. Oh, that's right. There's still not that many.
There's quite a few. Just missed all of them.
Oh, okay.
But please, if you want to submit a topic, please go to pottopicpodcast.com, please, and click on the submit a topic, please link for that form.
And send us some shit. This comes from Kwame.
Okay, this is one of the ones that I printed out today.
The topic is Earth.
Perfect.
Kwame asks, Earth.
Get ready for a few topics that are a connected theme.
Airbender theme by
No, no, other. I'm beginning to feel like it might be Dragon Ball Z. If it's Kwame.
You will see.
Can we just fucking talk about the Kwame Illuminati for a second?
Kwame, Earth, Wind, Fire, Water... With these powers combined, he is Captain Planet.
Okay, you may have predicted 4 out of 5 of the topics there. Okay, so Earth.
It's
a big blue thing.
It's not great for eating.
It's a very posh name for soil.
Named by a bunch of monkeys.
I would love to see it from space.
What if you were really into kink, but you wanted some posh way of saying it? So instead of saying dirty, you said, I'm very earthy. I'm grasping at shit straws.
Oh, I'm an earthy, earthy boy.
I'm an earthy boy.
Hit me again, mistress. I'm an earthy boy.
I can take it. I'm an earthy boy. The safe word is fire.
No. So earthy you could plant mushrooms in me.
Giordano!
Oh, God, when the mistress uses the safe word.
Oh, shit, write it down, put it in the host part. Oh, that is now my aim in life.
Want to sub and get the Dom to use the same.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. For sure.
No, just get the chainsaw. Just...
just close. Just glances. It just needs to glance. It just needs to
feel the vibration.
Just needs to rake the flesh a little bit. Just not really.
Just look me in the eyes and say, I feel like exactly like Daddy.
Giordano!
I really hope my girlfriend's not listening to this one.
Oh man, what else could you do?
With Earth.
Oh yeah, I mean with Earth. You could do plenty with Earth. I mean let's face it. I would fucking love to have a go at one of those gargantuan bucket machines.
Gargantuan bucket machines.
Yeah, they look like giant earth chainsaws.
Oh shit!
Oh,
yeah,
the
yeah,
ones
yeah,
they
yeah,
have
yeah.
at like coal mills.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
I would love because, but obviously it's not going to travel anywhere near as fast as I wanted to.
You're talking about the literal Earth fuck off machines.
Yeah. The ones in what Ghost Rider 2 that he gets into.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, have I seen? I think maybe I haven't seen Ghost Rider 2.
Oh, that's terrible!
A thing to be proud of. It's Ghost Rider 2.
It's another Nicolas Cage film,
but not a proper Nicolas Cage film.
So, oh wow, what did I learn recently? Oh yeah. So in the comics, there was a point where you got there was such a thing as the Red Hulk symbiote Ghost Rider.
Oh fuck!
Holy shit! Really?
I believe so. Yeah, I think this it turned up on a thing I was reading
because I hate Venom and Carnage and all that bullshit. I love Red Hulk and I hate Ghost Rider.
You hate Carnage?
Yeah.
Why? I love Carnage.
Why?
Well, because it's so rare just to have a villain that's just like, no, I'm just gonna fucking kill everything.
apart from a lot of them.
Well,
because usually there's
some justification there. There's some sort of moralistic thing behind it.
Joker needs to kill because Batman exists.
He's a chaos.
Yeah.
Yeah. He acts in opposition to Carnage. Yeah. Is just Carnage. And all you do is Carnage.
Every evil person in a Bond film.
They're all about the money.
They're all about power and money.
No, there are some that are just hell bent on destruction.
Like who?
Yeah, Tom. Like who?
Like who?
Wasn't Sean Bean one of the ones that was?
No, that was Revenge.
No, not Sean Bean. The other Scottish, the Scottish dude.
Oh, in Die Another Day.
Yeah, Die Another Day. What's his name from Trainspotting?
Yeah.
And at Stargate.
Universe.
Yeah, him. And Once Upon a Time. Yeah,
and
him.
It's really 51st State, and I can't
Sean,
remember.
No.
No, Nick, no.
Ah, God, it's right there.
Really good actor.
Yeah.
Oh, that one. He was up to just destroy everything.
Was he?
Yeah.
God, that was Revenge as well.
That was, yeah, but...
Because he got shot in the head, and the bullet was slowly moving towards his brain. Or something like that.
Okay, basically, I've just revealed that I need to destroy
Holy shit, was that him?
Yes.
Yeah.
How did I not spot that?
Because he shaved his head.
Because I probably also wasn't... I didn't really know him that much as an actor at that point, I guess. But I'm going to have to go fucking...
No, don't bother.
Yeah, but...
The only James Bond film worth watching...
GoldenEye.
Well, no, GoldenEye, God, yes. Oh, that's exactly what I was going to say. But also, well, because of that whole fucking Sean Bean death thing is fucking amazing. And Ivana Topp as well.
Yeah.
But
it's a good film.
It's a good
just
fucking
a
film.
Good
it's
fucking
a
film.
Camp-ass film. But also, any of the Timothy Dalton films are fucking amazing. I'm just going to put it out there.
Do you know what? I I never really got into Timothy Dalton as a Bond, so
point. He's the worst Bond, but he's so greatly camp. It's awesome. And he's not over the top like Patrick Moore. See, this is what happens. This is what happens when you...
Oh my god, what a brilliant vision. Fuck, the fucking game master of James Bond.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh. Yes, Blofeld, I see your point of view, but if you look out at the night sky, Orion is in the Ursula constellation.
That was a slip, however, let's talk about this film.
Oh, no, here's a question. What does the monocle do?
Oh, that's...
What is the Bond gadget of the monocle?
Oh, no, no. I was going to say shoot lasers, but that's too obvious. Maybe no, it's like a laser painting thing. So from a satellite missile platform, he can laser paint anything with his monocle.
No, yeah.
Sounds good.
I just like the idea. It's just like laser vision, so he can see... Then you've got the whole scene of him going through like a laser maze.
Shit, we got the album art now as well. That's going to be such a pain in the arse. Okay,
cool. No, you just have to Photoshop Patrick Moore's head onto Catherine Zeta-Jones' body from Entrapment.
Oh, that's fucking hot. No, what I was seeing was...
There's a thing I didn't realise I liked.
Planet Earth with a satellite missile platform and just, like, a slightly faded out, slightly transparent Roger Moore with a monocle and just, like, slightly reddened glow coming from it.
Oh, okay. I mean, not for the album art, but I think I've finally got a suggestion for Jim. We'll paint it. Which is just Patrick Moore as the games master, as a satellite around Earth, firing a laser from his games master monocle,
golden joystick in hand.
Yeah. What would the Bond film be called, though?
Earth. Looping back around to the topic. No.
Are we still on Earth?
Yeah. This is the problem with sending in a topic that's literally one word. We just ramble.
No, I prefer it.
Yeah, much respect for doing that.
I'm just thinking about those monocles now. Because the other thing you could do is you could superimpose Patrick Moore's head with the fucking power meter counters on top of Raditz's body.
Oh, from Dragon Ball Z.
From Dragon Ball Z.
CC power levels.
Yeah. Oh, man. RIP, that dude.
Yeah, to be fair.
But honestly,
Super God.
What was that Bond, like, that Bond actor's name? I can't remember. Patrick...
Roger Moore.
There we are.
The man who only knew how to act one way. The saint.
The thing is, he was quite open about it as well. He was just like, "Yeah, no, I'm a terrible actor.
Don't make no mint.
Why do you keep hiring me?"
Tom, do you want to grab us one from Il Hotti della
Potti? I really don't. I want to keep talking about this shit for hours, but unfortunately, we need to move on. Okay, let's get the big one. From the host. This one again is from Captain Sickbeard. You're right, Dom.
All right.
Well, you're right.
And it is classical interlude.
I put that in ages ago.
I'm not entirely sure.
I
can tell you one that happens in my own life quite often. It's when I've had far too much and I can't go to sleep. And I will put on an album on my phone called Best of Bach and just try and just lull myself to sleep. That's my classical interlude. It really works. It works every fucking time.
Can I make a suggestion for the 12-piece cello fugue from Heitor Villa-Lobos's Bacchianus Brasileiros?
Okay.
It's one of my favourite classical bits of all time. Absolutely. And it's a fucking banger.
Dom, do you have a vote?
I do. I can't remember what it's called. All I remember is the theme song from... It was that weird, weak game project. Like the college game. I can't... It was just a weird little flash games. There was a game called Gravity Head, and it's the song from that.
Cool. What we're actually going to have is Pavarotti saying elephants, yeah. Done.
Elephants? What?
Elephants, yeah. Oh, elephants.
Yeah.
I've still got nothing, mate.
There you go. That's the, and then the a cue Atari Teenage Riot fuck all for 3 seconds. Done.
Wicked. How long would that take up?
A lot of my editing time.
Well, I'll send over the track for my vote, and you can use that if you want. If not, do your thing. I don't care.
I'll splice in everything that we just
all at once.
Just, yeah, just to elongate it so we don't have to talk so long. Get boozing a bit more.
Oh man, why? Okay. We really need Elon Musk to fuck something up royally so we can start being referred to as elongate.
The previous topic, Earth.
Cool.
If Elon Musk and Patrick Moore join forces, we are fucked.
If Elon Musk goes evil, we have to send in Patrick Moore.
Oh shit.
Elon Musk is the Bond
shit.
Villain.
Deadeye himself. What's today's he? Right, cool. So, one from...
The community.
Yes.
Yes.
Have I got the next word?
Yeah, is it another relevant?
John. I doubt it.
Oh, emo kid.
If everyone was put on a leaderboard for everything they had ever done, what would be the highest scoring category? Spam bin.
Oh, fuck.
I think the spam bin is the last bit.
Most shit podcasts put out, regardless of cost or time invested.
I mean, you'd probably win on that one. The cost's more on your. I've got a feeling I'd make a good run on most catastrophic feet put in mouth. Because I'm being a thoughtless prick.
Okay, I thought you were getting pervy.
No, okay. No. I don't think any of my my particular proclivities I've done in any great excess. You'd have just flirt with that shit. Like kinks are fun because they're kinks. Like, you don't want to start moving into the realm of fetish, because that just becomes effort at that point.
Well, at the point where it becomes the norm, it's no longer a kink.
Yeah, it's a fetish, yeah.
Yeah.
You need it to get off. That's just...
Patrick Moore.
How did you know my safe word?
Talk astronomy to
that's
me.
The opposite of Jill Dando is Patrick Moore. I need Patrick Moore!
When the Dom is screaming Patrick Moore, you know it's gone too far.
Yes, madam, can I have Patrick Moore? Patrick Moore!
So
oh, no, Joel Dando.
I'm so going to use that next time.
I want Patrick Moore! Oh, God. This is the thing. I never really excel at anything.
Most times I've set myself on fire.
I've not set myself on fire too many times, so you definitely beat me on that.
Yeah.
Maybe once.
Okay.
I'm into the 20s, I think, now.
Can you give me a quick rundown of some of your most eventful setting yourselves on fire?
Last time I set fire to my crotch.
Ladies.
With my jeans. Well, the crotch with my jeans. And got to that point where it's just like, I need to put the fire out, but I can't just flail at it dramatically.
Because it's your crotch, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you were wearing jeans when you did that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I've set fire to my trainers.
Could you imagine something more?
No, I mean, just, I mean, I went about it a different way. Is all I'm saying. I know. We promised like absolute clarity and forthright honesty in here, but I don't want to tell that story.
Now we must know.
We're literally not going to carry on.
Well, okay. If I pull down my trousers and show you my crusty crotch. This comes from a time where I don't know, it involved like a bunch of PTFE, a Roman candle, and a gentleman named Monica.
Okay.
And that's all I'm legally allowed to say about it. Yeah. And other than that, the only other times I've set myself on fire is just having long hair every now and then. I'll catch the wisps at the front. Nothing fun. Not doing anything fancy like
blacksmithing.
Blacksmithing, yeah.
You're both doing fire wrong if you're catching yourself on fire.
Using an oxyacetylene torch to cut through
your face.
Inch plate. Essentially, the molten steel then fell into my baggy jeans, like into one of the folds, and it's just like my legs got really warm. Oh, I'm on fire. kick the fire off. I'm okay.
Yeah, no, never done that.
You never set yourself on fire?
No.
Like not even just like a bit of your clothes or something?
I'm not as pervy as you.
Not even in the kitchen?
No. Are you sure? Tom, you sure you never just set yourself on fire? Just like a little bit. Like you've never like thought, oh, I just set off a non-safety match on my face and then fuck it, there goes an eyeball sort of thing.
Striking against my pelvis.
Yeah, nothing like that. You've never done?
No.
No, never mind. That's my favourite.
So high scores.
I don't know. I mean, I would say like...
I can tell you a few high scores that we've both achieved together, you know what I'm saying? What? I scored 420 on that one. What?
I don't know. Maybe most time spent podcasting while wearing ice.
Yeah.
There. If you've been with us from the start, there was a point where I'd sprained my ankle and did entire podcast wearing ice.
We've done a lot of topless podcasting.
Yeah. I did a quick bit of naked podcasting because I was too hot. I seem to remember at some point. That was one of the first podcast in this studio.
I'm going to guess there's probably been at least 10 episodes of issues, should I say, of this podcast where we have been topless.
Yeah. No, I that's absolutely fine.
Can you work out which one?
Here's the clue. It's the ones where you can hear our nipples.
It's the telltale noise of my piercing.
There it is. Definitely not a pen.
Yeah, definitely not my biro against a beer glass.
I'm really sorry, John. I fear I've led a rather dull and unremarkable life.
So, interviews for a new podcast co-host. Much needed because I haven't lived much of a life either. But fuck it. My hard score's 420. And I'm just going to leave it at that.
How was being blacked out drunk?
Blacked out drunk?
Yeah. Hours lost through drunkenness.
Oh, yeah. Right. Oh, no. Blackout drunk? Oh, mate. Okay. I'd probably...
Oh, I mean, okay. We've hit a new vein.
Yeah, no, fucking well done, mate. There are significant portions of my life I don't remember. Like, there's a space of 10 days where I've got maybe...
You are average, terrible for brain damage.
Like, 2 hours memory a day.
Yeah, you are just really bad at that.
Yeah.
Mine is being able to endure the day after, I think. You've seen me leave when you used to live at the sawmill. Leave there after like 2 hours net, like not sleep but lay down and then go to work for 15 hour shifts and then come back to the party and then carry on for a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I've lost a lot of work precisely because I haven't done that.
Daz has lost a job because of doing that.
Oh, true.
That was the first proper party we ever threw.
Yes, the 72-hour party. Oh.
192-hour.
Oh, sorry, yes, the 72-hour was the record I set literally the week before. Yeah. And then you just came and went, fuck off!
Fuck off, here's a week.
Most spiders ever suffocated with foreskin.
In the bath, or...?
I mean, is that less shameful? Because if so, then yes.
It makes more sense because you're trying to get them to run in circles. Stealing a Ricky Gervais joke there, but... I know that's flies, but same thing.
The most ghosts...
How do you capture them?
Sorry?
With his foreskin. Well, yeah, it's a very talented affair.
No, you just suck them up, and then you're poof, into your foreskin. Obviously, it takes a bit more bending than that, but like
let the squirming do its work.
Oh, well, no, I let the foreskin do its work, and slowly suffocate the fuckers.
See, this is where I'm missing out, being circumcised. I just...
Oh, man. Yeah. Oh.
I've never known the pleasure of a spider under my foreskin.
Yeah, you're going to go to your grave, like, suffering that, and that's a real shame.
There is a Tesco bag over there. Can we try it tonight? can someone help me? It's gaffer tape in a Tesco bag.
Oh, is this time someone fucking recreate that like, a bit of Friends humour?
This is Tom's homemade.
No, that is a Friends joke, isn't it?
Friends did it!
Tom's trying to recreate his homemade Tenger egg.
Oh, fucking hell. That Tenger egg.
Oh, what would you do to, like, if you wanted to fashion your own sex toy from shit around the house, what would you do?
Kimmy? No way.
I mean, I tend to be quite pragmatic, so I'm wondering if I wouldn't just kind of think about it for a little while and then give up after just digging out a bit of a cucumber and then filling it full of butter.
I think that's too much work. I think sock.
Well, that's not a sex toy. That's a fucking catch mechanism.
Filled with lard. You got yourself a foopy all of a sudden, haven't you?
Oh, that's a proper Ned wank, that.
Yeah. You go for a posh pee, then you fuck it.
Well, you tie it up and then like those weird tubes.
Oh, like
the weird slimy tubes that you got in the shop.
Yeah. One of those like Morpheus strip type stress toy things, yes.
I don't know what I'd always considered it. I never got round to it, and that seems like I've kind of sold myself out of a potential experience. Like, it's not something to take any pride in, but it's like something that we've all thought about. So, for anyone who's not entirely,
what did you look at your hand? Like,
something we've all thought about.
I know you thought about it too, Prudence.
Yeah, yes, why is it talking to you? Yeah.
So for anyone who's not quite following along with us...
Dude, if you fuck Prudence, please videotape it and put it on YouTube.
I just...
Three fingers, where could they go?
That's called the chakra!
it wouldn't be the fingers, it'd probably be the crook of the elbow, to be fair.
Taking the hard end first, like you start.
The thing is, like, you get it in that way, you can then open it out.
Only if you had two Prudences. Anyway, what were you going to say?
It doesn't matter anymore.
No, it really doesn't.
I was going to try and describe one of those wet witty toys to like non-English listeners, but...
No. I think that we all have...
A water-filled balloons. Mobius strip is... Yeah. A water-filled Mobius tube is kind of... Yeah.
It's like a wet... Balloon donut.
Ah, yeah, no, it's like, yes. Do you know what? It's a fucking rubber churro.
Yeah, but no.
But I'm not filled.
No, because it's got a hole in the middle.
Yeah, no, so that's not filled. It's basically
a churro rig, but not sexy.
With an opening at the end.
Not an egg. I did have a moment the other day where I had to explain to a new girlfriend that there is a video of me online reviewing a sex egg. Interesting conversation.
Oh, yeah, that is.
But the words followed right, where is it?
She started listening to this podcast, so I'm just not going to say.
Don't worry. you've got, what, 97 more episodes of safety? If she doesn't binge listen.
She hasn't got the commitment to start at the beginning.
Oh, could you imagine if she did?
Shit, son. There's so many stories.
Too many.
I mean, no, there's no stories.
I mean,
next topic.
I mean, we got to be closing on like 300 hours of content at this point.
Well, I was
right?
trying to work this out. Yeah, so average like
2 hours,
two and a quarter hours, I reckon, probably every podcast. So what's that?
So when we hit 100, that's going to be what 250?
Yeah.
2.25 hours times 97. 218 and a quarter hours.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there you go, folks. That's
so much
shit
of your life wasted.
That's
218.
That's almost an hour of. Sorry, that's almost a week of content, isn't it? 24. Is it not?
240. No,
let me divide it.
That's almost 10 days of content.
Oh, oh, 10, yeah. That's
10 days solid listening. 24 hours a day for 10 days.
So there it is, endurance. If like
if we, you we can endure
you,
that.
We've got you. If you ever really want to waste
like
your
nine
life.
Nine days.
If you ever really want to waste your life, we got you covered. You can do it over and over again.
And that's not talking about all the three bonus episodes either.
True. Which, fuck, we never got around to doing the Tremors marathon, did we?
Bruv, I've got the bookmarks. We are doing the Tremors marathon.
Mate, so once I'm set up at the new place,
yeah,
that's probably going to be fucking perfect
prime
for
time.
It. Because, mate, the sofa we're getting, and like the big dining table, and we can get some shit for some baffling. Oh, it's fine.
And I'm going to bring over a computer and set that up because I also have all the Tremors video games to play.
Oh, shit! Oh, shit!
I've literally downloaded, bought all of the Tremors
downloaded
films.
From Steam.
All the no, the games are completely fucking bullshit. They're really online flash games, but all of the films, all the TV shows, all of video games. There are no books. I wonder why.
Are there no books?
As far as I'm aware, I did check. I literally typed in Tremors Media and tried to find everything I could.
Tremors discography.
Discography.
There aren't any Tremors books.
I think there are only novelizations of the films.
Oh, now that's an interesting thing to learn. Because the thing is, the dude who plays Bert owns owns the Tremors license, really, doesn't he?
Yeah.
And he does nothing else with his time.
Yeah. Apart from raking all the profit.
Okay, cool. That's an idea.
Have you ever seen Tremors 4?
No, is that the one in the Wild West?
Yeah.
I believe we started watching it in at a time when we were very, very sleepy.
Yeah, I think it was me and Andy that managed to stay awake the entire film because we are the Tremors lovers.
Right, yeah. Oh, man, it's been so long. I love Tremors 2. What a film.
They're all awesome. Like, literally everything that's come out with Tremors is either, like, stupid good or good stupid. It's in those two classifications. And it's perfect. So, your high score. Next topic.
Actually, do you know what? Something that got left out of what I've been up to this week. In the past, I've seen Sudoku as a thing. And I've looked at it, and I've kind of looked at the lines and gone...
It's fun.
Well, it's like, oh, one, two, three. Well, okay, there's more than one gap there. I don't know how to fill that in. And I didn't really have kind of a brain set up for logical analysis at that point.
You like Picross?
I like watching people play it.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. I've never like, for instance, like when you watch Dan Rikert, just go, well, because this and that, and then that can only be that. Like, I could never really follow along with that at all. Like that kind of quick kind of logical processing has always been kind of, something I didn't really have access to. But over the last week, I ended up just kind of watching over somebody's shoulder at work as they were just doing a Sudoku. And then all of a sudden, it all just started clicking. And so I found a websudoku.net or .com or whatever it is.
Yeah.
And they have, oh my God, billions of Sudoku. But because they got billions of Sudoku, that means that you could do a search for a Sudoku. They say, oh, what number do you want? So you could absolutely just kind of put in like 800-85-69-420.
Yeah.
And there's a Sudoku for that.
Yeah, cool.
So I've had so much fun doing like boob Sudoku. 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69, 69 surprised. My favorite part was when I, the girl who I was watching sort of do Sudoku and then helping her do it, she said, "Oh, can you print some out for me?" And I did. And as she was finishing one, I sort of pointed out, it's like, look, it says boob 69420. Oh, you're such a child, Taz. Cool.
Nice.
Nice.
Where shall I start?
Whenever you want, mate.
A German-based doctor has invented breast implants made from titanium.
Is that it? Is that all we're getting from it?
I know. I was waiting for reactions, but that fell flat on his face.
No. I'm just trying to. Because it's the rainbow coated titanium. You know, that heat-treated titanium.
Well, I mean, I'm assuming that they are for super-powered type people because silicon implants
like
would
Jones
just get
kind of
squished and destroyed. So they need to be titanium to hold up to their epidermal elasticity.
Oh, here's one for you, Tom.
Well done.
Thank you for me.
You can actually put this one to some test at the Christmas period.
Okay.
Landlords have found the best way to get rid of drinkers at closing time at Christmas is to play Cliff Richard.
Okay. I only found this out last week. So in my pub, you can use the secret DJ app.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So yesterday we had two fuckers that were just completely just in a corner necking constantly. And they were a very attractive couple, don't get me wrong, but they were just constantly over each other all the time. And it was getting a little bit awkward for staff, like they couldn't go over and take orders. It was getting a bit awkward for anyone sitting around them because while they didn't mean to sit near anyone, people just kind of like eventually sat near them. And it was getting a little bit awkward. So I just went on and put sexual healing. Let's get it on. And fuck, what was the last one?
No, I need
hot chocolate.
I believe a miracle.
Yeah, no, the sexy one. God damn it.
No, I mean that shit needs some Steel Panther.
Oh yeah, no.
My heart belongs to you, but my cock is community property.
And you can hear that track on Seventh Dimension's new album. okay, have you got another one?
I've got two more.
Oh, go on.
Thieves who stole a public toilet in Belarus city of Gomel accidentally kidnapped a man still locked inside.
Okay.
And this one's a bit of a head turner.
Okay.
A groom has been given away at his wedding by his ex-wife. His best man was his ex's new boyfriend.
Sounds like Louis Theroux missed the beat, didn't he?
Oh, so,
listen to the boopers.
So Heather and I were talking about our future wedding, and it's very similar to that.
Wait, so it's a wedding that's going to be held in the future, but it's future themed?
No, it's, yes. It's yes. Definitely not future themed. Yes.
Titanium boots.
Yes.
No, mate, this shit is. But like there was this realization that actually her best maid, like her maid of honor, might be Kel, my ex. Which actually I think is fucking awesome.
Oh no, absolutely.
I mean that shows some fucking excellent brand synergy.
Oh god, that just ruined it for me.
Yeah. Right, shall we carry on with the show?
Yeah.
Nah.
Well, who's next? Oh,
me.
No, I believe is it you?
I think it's me.
What does the book say?
Captain Sickbeard did classical interlude, which was me. Then John did high school.
Oh, it's you.
Taron.
No, it's me. Oh, pass me the one pot.
One from the hosts, one from us.
Right, clap me in.
Why?
I don't know. All right, cool. Okay.
To the floor, Mr. Willmore.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Take it off, take it off.
For my next trick is one from the host pot.
Yes.
Tom, I will never keep it on.
Yeah, I know. This show's been falling flat on its face for years. Go on.
Tom.
Shit.
The liberal sex positive paradox.
What?
Hang on. I can't. Oh, kink shaming is your kink. Oh.
I told you this topic was coming up.
Kink shaming is your kink.
Yeah, okay. So you're a liberal-minded fellow, and you don't want to yuck any yum, but...
It turns out your
kink is yucking yums. I don't know where to take this topic.
Oh,
but...
I mean, I could you imagine that, like, you both share a kink of
there's just this guy just sat in the corner of like torture garden or something, just screaming at people.
Oh, okay, okay. So
put your clothes on, you dirty fuck.
Should be locked up. So, Taryn, you have inspired me. Like, if I was ever to go to Torch Garden, I'd be wearing a full pith helmet and explorer outfit.
Oh, mate, yeah, the colonial chic.
Yeah, 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 absolutely. There is nothing like a bit of King Leopold just to get me off, you know what I'm saying?
I just imagine it's all colonial outfit, but made out of latex.
I just want to walk into a village and just basically say I'm God and then accept it.
Yeah, I mean, I only recently learned that... So I was always confused why Rhodesia changed its name, because Rhodesia always sounded
now,
like...
Now, what?
I believe, yeah. At least, part, like... So a lot of it is on... A lot of Rhodesia was on the Zambezi, so it might now be Zimbabwe?
That sounds right to me.
But I can't say for sure.
It's but this whole master race bullshit, isn't it?
Rhodesia always sounded like a really, really guy. It sounds like an African place to me. No, it's named after Rhodes, yeah, who was one of the explorers who just went in and like, hey,
it's the most racist thing ever.
This is ours now. And also, I've just killed you. So, okay, that absolutely makes sense that you change.
Nobody's left. This is now my land. I call it Rhodesia.
I'm sorry, but if you haven't listened to Behind the Bastards yet, go and listen to the King Leopold fucking episodes on Behind the Bastards by Robert Evans. My God, the point where they were saying they were literally hooking up batteries so they could, to their hands, so when they shook chiefs of a tribe's hand, they would blow them across the room and go, you know, that's white people power. Oh. And just take over an entire village.
Oh no 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 no! That wasn't Congo. That was Algeria. Because there was a I think it was Algeria. There's going to be an uprising of.
I swear that was the Congo.
Oh no, sorry. Yeah, you're right. That's a different thing. That's a thing that I read rather than the thing I listened to.
Yeah.
But yeah, no. There's another similar story which I believe was in Algeria, which I think the story's somewhere on themodernrogue.com. But basically there's kind of one of the religions or one of the indigenous thing, like there were some mystics coming up and they were sort of spurring an uprising, so France sent along some of their magicians and just said, ha ha, look at this magic. Yeah, and that fucking, and that they used that to quell a rebellion.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You play into someone's folklore, religion, or superstition, you can completely control them.
They tried with the mimes first, but it just fell flat. They were all stuck in a box.
Oh, yes, sir. Hold your hands up in triumph. That was a good fucking joke. So what if yucking yums was your yum?
I can only assume it would take so much talking about it beforehand just to make it work.
Just to explain it to someone.
Because this is the thing. This is one of the secrets of BDSM. This is one of the things, like, a lot of people got really upset with, what's this fucking 50 Shades of bullshit, is that's just rape and shit. Like actual BDSM relationships, there's a lot of communication, there's a lot of duty of care. So if your whole thing is yucky and yum, he's just like, oh, I love being whipped, but I need to berate you while you do it. Oh, you pervert.
Always only measure
you
once.
Fucking degenerate.
I hope your mother's proud of you.
Okay, so I'm going to try and push my own limits with this one.
Oh.
Okay, so...
Hold on to your hat.
Okay, so... You know what me and my sister are like?
Yes.
It's always been a joke about the incest shit.
Yeah.
Always. So.
The Ryan family crest motto is always be fucking your family.
A.
It sounds so much better in Latin.
ABFF. So, with the modern uprising of incest porn, what if my kink was to fuck my sister... but hate the fact that I'm fucking my sister, and that's actually the thing that got me off.
Oh, God. I mean, that's...
For endurers at home, let me explain. This is a long-running thing. Me and my sister literally talk about anything. We are very open. We are very honest. Oh, God, we are very liberal.
That's like a fucking three-way...
But we occasionally try and weird people out by doing stupid... jokes
like fucking them each other,
basically
in front
like
of people.
Trying to seduce each other, I mean, but not
that as a king. That's like a fucking three-way Ouroboros. It's all feeding
up. Mate, if I could eat my own tail, I would. If my sister could eat my tail, though, much better. And that's yummy. The kind of joke you can expect from me and my sister. This is not gonna play on the internet, is it?
No, never will. No. So I got something that caught me off guard was, what was it? I think it was Sunday. I got a WhatsApp from host Hal. And he just sent me a link to an Xvideos video, which was, I will find the name for you. So that if you want to go and have a look at it, it's not sexy. It is thoroughly entertaining, though.
Is it a proper, like, e-fucked kind of material?
No. It's not that far. It's obviously all, like, built up and staged and for the Halloween season.
Okay.
But it's on xvideos.com, and it's Demon Girl Triple Penetration Satanic Ritual. And, like...
It's his new album from Talanas.
Within like the first 40 seconds, it includes the line, that's some good ritual. But the bit that kept playing through my head is towards the end, during the cum shots, there's just this one line of, here's a gong, three cums for Satan. Yes.
Four comes for Satan.
My following comments.
The picture of the count.
The picture of count von count. Like every time I'm hearing it, it's three comes for Satan.
Exactly where my mind went. Okay. We both have the same kind of brain damage.
Yeah, really. Indeed. Oh, okay.
Okay.
I've just had a new idea for a topic.
Go on. Come on, let's roll with it. Let's freestyle the topic.
Well, a new pot rather.
Topic hijacking.
Like, find a link to an entertaining bit of porn, like a very silly bit of porn, and obviously without playing anything over over the air. We'll describe it and then listen, like watch it and like talk shit about it.
I can't
like, basically
the name.
Do one of those reaction videos.
Shall we just play porn over the air?
What was it? I think it was Alien Porntopsy.
Alien porn. Oh, that's good.
Google searching.
Oh, that's very good.
Alien Porntopsy.
Just because
keep filling the air. Go on.
Just because the makeup was so terrible.
Oh, fantastic.
proper like what the alien from Alien Autopsy looked like.
Oh, very good. Very good. Yeah, I
can't spell it well enough to get this dunk going. Do you want to try and spell it and I'll try on the air?
I mean, I can
fill the air.
I mean, if we do this, we start linking porn sites into our meta tags, then that might include, like, increased listenership. Because let's face it, a lot of people going to these porn sites aren't hugely discerning in their tastes.
Anyone listening to this podcast is not particularly discerning
in
their tastes.
And you see
either.
The link in the
Venn diagram. On a completely separate note, I don't know why this reminded me of this, but I think it may have been the fact that Devin Townsend released his Strapping Young Lad album called Alien, and then it got caught in my head. But I finally experienced Gojira how it's supposed to be experienced.
Oh, how's that?
They made a song called Flying Whales.
Right.
I hate Gojira. No, I don't hate Gojira. I don't appreciate Gojira because they sound like Sixth and Opeth to me. They're too clinical. There's no soul. There's no feeling behind their music. It's just too technical.
I'm completely with you. I actually found their last album, their newest album, kind of bucked that a little bit. It was a lot more interesting than anything else they've done.
I'll be willing to give it a listen because obviously they're very talented musicians, but
it's a lot more atmospheric, a lot more melodic.
Okay, so Devin Townsend for me is like sort of just a little bit more soulful than those three bands. Okay. So Gojira, I've listened to a bit of Gojira in the last month or so.
Mm-hmm.
And they have this song called Flying Whales.
Yeah. Tell me about the Flying Whales.
They sample whale song. In this fucking song. And every time I hear it, I just have to stop myself from going singing along because I've now learned it. I've now learned the whales as lyrics. I just go.
You couldn't find it, Dom.
Okay, all right, never mind. We had a little bit of a moment of dead air feel behind. Bollocks. Okay.
Well, I mean, I've got a quick one that we could watch and review. It's one I've mentioned a number of times before. And Endurance, if you haven't gone and watched it before, then you've been fucking wasting your fucking time.
I did think of the other one was the UHF Weird Al Yankovic porn parody.
Oh, VHF. UHF?
UHF.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, that's good.
The weird porn parody of Weird Al Yankovic, and you're sitting there going, It's very nice, but it's also Weird Al, and I don't know how I feel.
He just got a star on
Hollywood
Walk of Fame. Yeah. Well deserved. Anyway, this is real bad radio. This is really bad radio.
Oh, it is about to get worse.
How's that? Oh, it's in German.
No, go on.
There we are. So we're currently looking at a blonde lady and a brunette lady at a bar. Just to the right, a man's approaching, and he's kind of looked very interested, and he's just lifting up the brunette lady's skirt, and then
she's just shocked.
Oh, and she's interested, and suddenly the blonde lady's interested as well, and it's very. I mean, the setup is fucking porn parody perfect. He's just
straight into the ass. Why are we watching? No. We're not just going to watch porn while Endurers try and listen to us.
Well, no, this is the thing. I wasn't planning on having the porn come through the system.
Anyway. What if it was your king to yuck yums? It'd be bad. Right, next topic.
What if it was your king to yuck your own yums?
Yuck your own yums?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I hate myself for doing this.
Oh, no, that's literally just flagellation.
Kind of subbing a little bit, isn't it?
It's flagellation, isn't it? It's just beating yourself.
I'm such a dirty boy. I'm such an earthy boy. Oh, look at me watching Theresa May. I'm such an earthy boy.
I'm sorry, but high rankings. You know that video of Theresa May walking out on stage and she's dancing to the music?
Yes.
Okay. Put to DJ Fresh. I know. Who's it? Who did Mr. Happy?
Oh, Andy T.
No.
Yeah?
Enzo, innit?
I thought it was, Andy C.
No.
Well, it's the Andy C version that I've always listened to, but yeah, fine.
Bricks Don't Roll. He titled it Brexit Don't Roll.
Oh, it's nice.
So good. Anyway, gonna cut that. Rikard, original OG, with which we've pimped so many times this podcast already, has submitted a topic, and it is... Why did the chicken cross the road?
Mmm.
Okay.
To go see his friend the idiot.
Okay, so there have been several people in the last couple of years that I have blown their mind saying it's a death allegory. So he's crossed the road to get to the other side, because it means getting to the other side of the road and also dying.
To meet his friend.
To be run over. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Absolutely. I believe...
Several 30-ish odd people.
I believe that's one of those jokes that was kind of made after the fact, requiring a kind of more nihilistic point of view.
I think that was the original joke.
I mean, like, the reason, like, the chicken crossed the road was to go, like, express significant disgust and judge the neighbor's eggs. And then really get off on it.
What, yucking is yum?
Oh, jump down, yeah. Though. Jump down, though.
So, I mean, why did the chicken cross the road? It is one of the great questions of our time. It could be to get to the other side. Is just getting to the other side a step onto something else? Like, is that like the first step in the 5,000 step
this
journey?
This isn't Frogger. It's not like to get to the other side, then he has to get onto the back of a crocodile.
Well, this is the thing. No one's ever spoken about exactly how congested that road is. If it's just a road by itself, or is it a road with traffic? You know, this changes it entirely.
Is it a main byway?
Is it a high street?
Carriageway?
Yeah, is it a dual carriageway? Is it a motorway he's trying to cross?
Exactly.
Four-lane motorway.
Or is there even any meaning to it whatsoever?
Is it a runway?
Or did it literally just see some corn on the middle? You know, these are the questions that really don't need to be asked. But the important thing as human beings is that we ask them anyway. And that's how we got to the moon.
Why did a chicken cross the road to get to the motherfucking moon?
See? It's a much better joke. One of these days, Alice.
First one KFC of these days, in space.
Pow. I mean, I had fried chicken for the first time in ages yesterday.
Really?
Because
you moved out of Lewisham, that's why.
No, I was late for work, and I realised the only way I was going to get a lunch beforehand was on my way to the station. I walked past a PFC and saw there was no one in there, but knew they would have something ready to go. So kind of quick dive in, quick dive out. All of a sudden, I've got a box of chicken that I really don't want to eat, but so hungry though.
That's why the Taran crossed the road.
Well, that's why the town crossed the pavement.
To get to the chicken.
To get to the chicken. Tom, what are you up to? Tom?
I'm trying to find dirty chicken cross the road jokes, and I'm just coming up with nothing.
I can just make them up.
Okay, go on.
I mean, they won't be particularly good. They'll be kind of more in the American style of humour than the English style. But
okay.
So, Tom, why did the chicken cross the road?
Why?
To fuck your dad's ass. Why did the chicken cross the road?
I've got one.
Because he wanted to double team your dad's ass with the first chicken.
I've just actually invented. It's not a dirty joke, but I have not invented it. I'm sure someone else has done this.
What?
Why did the rooster cross the road? To cuckoo doodle do it.
All right, let's have another topic.
Next topic.
And it took a lot of brain power, this drunk. So.
Oh, and I've got nothing but respect for it.
This is a good joke. Why did the chicken cross the road?
Why did the chicken cross the road?
To roll in mud again. Why, you might ask? Because he's a dirty double crosser.
Well,
I feel like that was that requires another part to the joke.
Maybe
cross the road, get to the other side. Why did he cross it again? To roll in mud because he's a double. Yeah, would seem to be the.
Why did the horse cross the road?
Because the chicken owed him money.
It's better than the actual answer, yeah. So I'm going to leave it.
Yeah, 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 go for it.
Because the chicken needed a day off.
Oh, yeah, no, fuck that. Right, what have we got, Dom?
This is from John.
You're right, emo kid.
IP address.
I've not sorted out the whole like European Privacy Act bullshit yet. So let's not reveal the fact that I know everyone's IP address.
Oh, hang on, no, I've got the particular. Sorry, hang on, page. Sorry, that. One second. I've got the particular GDPR thing as it relies to. To podcast. There we are. Always be doxing.
Okay. Why did the chicken...
Well, as you say it, IP address 123.
Why did the chicken cross the football pitch?
To dox your house, no.
Because he was a foul.
Oh, that's...
This is from John. Okay,
I mean, that's actually made me quite angry, Tom. That's made me quite angry.
Why did the dinosaur cross the road?
Because chickens weren't alive yet.
Yeah, they haven't evolved yet. Yeah.
All right. This one could be part of Taryn's horror story about Prudence.
Oh, yeah. Let's go back to the heady days of Prudence.
You're fingery bastard.
You're yeah. clicking
fingery
her...
bitch.
Excuse me.
Bitched.
You're clicking around on YouTube and stumble upon hundreds of numbered videos of unedited footage of your room, your car, at work, and at a restaurant, etc. What do you do? Basically, you find a YouTube channel of your life.
Monetize.
Copyright strike.
I mean, I try and figure out every single one of those camera angles, and if I can, sort of estimate a rough timing of the shots. And then always make sure my spread butthole is there.
So basically, if you're wearing the Truman Show, it'd be your true man show.
So as the numbers go through, there'll just be a certain section of videos where it's just you sort of pointing until your finger is pointing at the camera and then just slowly looking at it going...
Well, I mean, the thing is, actually, to be fair, if you were unhappy about it and you wanted it taken down off of YouTube, the only thing you need to do is always have Nazi iconography playing somewhere in the background, which is fucking hilarious. Like, I've recently discovered that a bunch of neo-Nazis used this to get one of ContraPoint's videos taken down.
The most liberal fucking YouTube channel ever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. But she featured a bunch of Nazi film stock, mm-hmm. to like make a point about fascism. And yeah, there was a fucking a big right wing storm. Like, oh, they showed all this, blah, 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 got it shut down. It was like, right, cool. Well, that seems like an easy hack at this point.
At the moment, due to the algorithm that YouTube refuses to tell the creators how it works. Because they're in fear that if they tell the creators how the algorithm actually demonetizes and takes down,
well, they'll be
people
it.
Will figure out workarounds.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, they will, to be fair. In truth, they actually will.
So, yeah, there's a constant battle of basically YouTube trying not to demonetize everyone, but also demonetizing everyone.
I mean, I wonder if the development of algorithms is going to be one of the powering factors of the development of the human of human intelligence. It's like, okay, so we've developed these algorithms. Now we need to think about, figure out how to work around them.
No, it goes back further. So man learned to think. And man taught something else, not quite to think, but also sort of simulate thinking.
Yeah.
At which point man needed to manipulate the thing that he thought he taught to think, how to think, in order to make money from it.
Oh, God, this is one of the things that's really, really, like, worrying at the moment, is there's a bunch of auto policing initiatives going on at the moment where they're like, if something's reported or something is suggested might be happening in a place, algorithms will suggest, okay, we need more police there. And it basically is kind of like a pre-crime kind of thing. Like
Minority Report style.
Yeah, not quite there. Because no one's going to be arrested. But the thinking is that if there's a presence there, ahead of time, there's going to be less trouble happening because people aren't going to do it if the police are actively there. But the thing that hasn't really been accounted for, particularly in Europe and the West in general, is a lot of these algorithms are built off of police response to certain things. So they're probably going to be inherently racist. But you kind of hit a point where no one's going to be prepared to admit or really talk about how anything works if you do, you're going to have to start dealing quite hard with the institutional racism involved in Western policing. Yeah.
Slightly scary.
Oh, well, it's utterly, utterly terrifying, really. The other problem you got with that is if you start developing ways in which a crime simply can't be committed, that suddenly starts removing the ability to reform law. So, for instance, the example I saw the other day is if for instance, you've got buses that have a sort of camera system that start kind of face recognizes and kind of cross match identity profile people who are about to get on. Mm-hmm. I've just thrown a lot of words there because some of them will stick. But say, for instance, this existed in Harriet Tubman's time. Harriet Tubman wasn't just a woman who just got on a bus one time and was tired and decided to move. She was already an active. She was an activist.
I'm gonna have to stop you there just for a thing.
Yeah, go for it.
It wasn't Harriet Tubman. Harriet Tubman ran the railroad during the.
Sorry, not no, no, no. You're right. Not Rosa Parks. My bad. I do mean Rosa Parks. My bad.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. But yeah, thank you for that. But like the thing is that if you start setting up systems whereby laws can't be broken at all, then that means broken laws can't be reformed.
Yeah.
Which I mean, all of a sudden, whoops. I think it's pretty much all I've got to say on the matter. Yeah, I've been watching and reading some shit recently.
Yeah.
Oh, I finally picked up a copy of Machiavelli's The Prince.
Oh,
I can't wait to read it. I really can't. I'm currently reading Catch 22 at the moment, which is a lot of fun.
Charles Stross.
No.
Catch 22.
Oh, fuck. I can't remember the author's name. Catch 22. It's a...
Jeff Goldblum.
I haven't seen the film,
stars
actually.
Stars as both
However,
sides of the argument.
I understand that there's going to be a series on some platform starring George Clooney.
And Jeff Goldblum.
Well, of course, in spirit, if not in actuality.
Jeff Goldblum stars as... Everything. George Clooney in
Jeff Goldblum.
Oh, that's hot. That is really hot.
Jeff Goldblum playing George Clooney, who's playing Jeff Goldblum.
So, Truman Show You, basically, is the topic.
The YouTube channel that is Taryn's life.
Oh, God. Wow.
You still need to put up the video of you hanging upside down in a tree.
The video? I mean, the photo's up somewhere.
No, the video of, like, Luke walking through the house, taking a video and just finding you in a tree upside down.
Oh!
You promised that to the podcast.
I did. I ran into a problem with that. in that
where you were really the fucked up.
No, because the thing is, I wasn't really fucked up at the time at all. Mate, do you know what? In order to get into that tree, hang upside down and stay there for a minute, you can't be that fucked up. Especially if you want to get out again. No, the problem I found is I suddenly realized that my phone editing ability is you can just turn a video 90 degrees. And the second, so it was filmed landscape.
I cannot edit that.
The thing is, once it's tipped into its correct orientation, it's not quite as funny as when viewed on its side. And I can
edit that.
I couldn't figure out which way to do it.
We have a Bex, but not that Bex. She can do that.
Wicked. I'll send you both videos and you see what you think.
Cool.
Right. Shall we do another thing?
Yeah, this one's boring.
From the pop.
Sorry, John.
who's that?
So what would you do? I just put copyright strike on it.
Okay, hang on. So, Captain Sickbeard. Captain Sickbeard. John. I think it's me. So.
Go for it.
One from the host pop.
Let's do it.
And we have a very small topic. How it's about Chris.
Hello.
Ooh.
A world without alcohol. Better or worse? Worse? Are you fucking kidding me?
We just find another crutch.
Yeah, which could be much worse. As you know, I know many crutches that are much better than alcohol.
It would basically be the argument of, like, what if alcohol was banned but cannabis was made legal, or heroin, or...
Okay, so basically, a bit extreme there with the heroin thing, but...
Well, no, if you looked at, like, 1918, when you could have, from Fortnum and Mason, sent your boys on the front a lovely care package, which contained cigarettes, chocolate, heroin, cocaine.
But, okay, so this is... Not a world where alcohol is illegal, it's a world without alcohol.
Yeah.
So we've never known the pleasure.
Yeah, but we would have found something else that would have...
Oh, absolutely would have found something else.
Oh, of course, humans need their vices, but...
Yeah.
What do you think would be the fallback? What would be the fallback vice?
Chivit coffee.
No, coffee doesn't quite cut it. Like...
The
history of coffee, especially in Islamic countries, is kind of interesting because
it's gone through the same process that alcohol and weed has over time.
It's become taboo and then become completely accepted and then taboo again, and
much like Canada at the moment.
Canada's anti-coffee.
No, cannabis. Pro cannabis now.
I love that video that came out the day cannabis was now legal across all of Canada. There is a guy with his shirt pulled up like Conholio in Beavis and Butthead the movie, just smoking a fat bong out of his back garden, just dancing to a bus full of people, and then realizes he's being videotaped and just runs away. It's like, it literally took 6 hours before someone was a complete nut and not bed.
So the whole thing about Canada legalizing cannabis, like, it kind of got conflated with the fact that gay marriage was illegal there, and it was weird how I kept seeing a couple of memes kind of conflating the two. It's like, oh yeah, two gays should lie together, they should be stoned, but like, stoning is legal. The one that always really tickled me about the was it Deuteronomy or was it Leviticus? I can't remember. But the one that always tickled me was like, if a man should have his hair long, he should be stoned. It's more or less the
not in the Bob Dylan sense.
But that's how I read it. It's just like, oh,
everybody
fucking way ahead of you, Old Testament. At the time. For legal reasons.
Hypothetically would be.
I was about to say, I'll give it 5 years till it's here.
Well, I mean, it's
I hope so.
Medicinal has just been legalised here, is it?
Certain
very, very, very strict medicinal. So it's,
it's like cancer pain-killing medication.
To be fair, like, with a fucking no-deal Brexit looming, they're going to need something to, like, lift the economy.
Satiate the masses.
We get rid of the Europeans, you need to whack up the fucking Dutch. You know what I'm saying?
Let's turn us into the party capital of the world.
Yeah. Oh, Brexit. Hello, my old friends.
I'd almost forgotten it was happening.
Mm. Mm.
Which I probably shouldn't, given Finnish girlfriend.
marry her now.
Jesus Christ.
You need that green card before.
Oh, she's been over here long enough, hasn't she? Like 5 years?
No.
She not?
On and off. Anyway,
well, she needs to fucking go back home then.
Jesus. He's been on.
Brexit is Brexit.
Enough. He's had enough tea and enough cupcakes, given the Church of England.
Did you ever see that Twitter rant that some massively idiotic guy posted when he thought that he wanted to boycott Yorkshire tea? because the tea leaves weren't brewed in Yorkshire. Grown in Yorkshire. He found out they were grown in India.
Yeah,
and Yorkshire tea just took the piss out
of him. It started off with him saying, it's like, we don't need Indian trade. We got Yorkshire tea. And Yorkshire tea just said, we get our leaves from India. My whole life's been a lie. okay, cool. What's up next? Who drew? Cool. Where drew?
That was me.
That was you? From?
No, come on. World without alcohol.
Oh, shit, you're right, we haven't really talked about it.
We would find the new vice. It would be getting off on kink shaming. Sucking someone's yum-yum.
Sucking someone's yum-yum?
I don't...
I kind of feel... So given the ability to operate and the lowering of inhibitions... that's kind of similar in a way to alcohol.
Eckies.
I'm thinking either it's going to be weed or amphetamine is going to become
MDMA,
the modern crutch.
Ecstasy. That would be the way to go.
Yeah.
For society.
And what a especially without alcohol, what a fucking difference that would make.
Okay, so you remove the alcoholic wife beating, destroying your life thing. The bad side, if you're going to go for amphetamines, is you're going to be amphetamine damaged, so you're no longer going to feel pleasure. But you're not going to beat people.
Well, the assumption would be that it's the dosage is controlled in such a way that it's kind of difficult to reach.
This is
points.
Mankind. You're not going to control dosage.
Not entirely. But I mean, for instance, you can have quite a tipsy night with a reasonably small amount of amphetamine.
Yeah.
And it does make a huge difference. Just weekend gone, there was a chap who took. After we got back from the pub, there was a chap who took half a pill, and he was a bit leery beforehand. Mm. And then we got back to the place, he took half a pill, and I just kind of saw him sitting in a corner, and every now and then just kind of collapsing into his own knees. And I was like, do you know what? I reckon that person needs a cuddle. So I just went and sat in his lap and had a cuddle for a while. And
completely lying his world. Yeah.
So yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It was completely different to someone just fucking necking shots after shots after shots. So it would be a very, very different thing. And again, the same again with weed, which, so what, amphet is an upper, isn't it?
Definitely.
Yes, of course, it definitely is. Weed.
My friends have told me, yes.
weed is a downer, and it's while you can get paranoid on weeds.
Yeah.
That results in a lot less violence than the fucking egomania that comes with heavy drinking.
And that's the thing. Alcohol is such a socially and physically destructive drug.
So
compared to a lot of things that are illegal, but
now I can't I can't really offer...
He says, completely slurring his words.
I can't really offer a firm historical basis on this, but it was an interesting theory I read, which is that alcohol was developed shortly after the global climate changed significantly enough that where hallucinogenic mushrooms were quite common, and they were used in like animistic cultures. So just kind of, like small tribal cultures. And, you know, as the climate changed, they kind of became less and less and less. So it's then that we found other ways to get fucked up. And that's where we got alcohol mm-hmm. from.
So, I can't wait to lend you this Robert Evans book, by the way.
Oh, mate, I'm sure. I'm
so close to finishing it.
I'm wondering, like, how things would have changed had, like, hallucinogenics just kind of remained as the go-to. Okay, once a week, we're going to get fucked up on this.
See, I think hallucinogenics are a little bit too hardcore for day-to-day escapism. Like, but there's a reason why alcoholism is a thing, is because it's a day-to-day process. Mm. You don't really see people that are taking hallucinogenics day-to-day to be coping with reality. Apart from, like, the extreme cases.
But, so, I mean, this is the other side of the thing. Like, in animistic cultures, and, like, cultures that have kind of grown up around, like, the taking of hallucinogenics, the whole taking of those particular substances is kind of, it's ritualistic, and it's supported, and it's...
Almost
it's,
religious.
Yeah, exactly. And it's such a big part of the culture that, like, maybe you don't need the everyday kind of trickle, just like escapism.
Maybe you don't, but I do.
I don't know. It's actually, that's a lot more interesting question than I thought it was going to be.
Okay, so if you could pick, okay, personally, if you could pick a substitute for alcohol, what would you pick? Ooh. Dom, what do you think?
I haven't really done anything, so I can't really decide.
Given folklore stories and theoretical friends that maybe sat around this table, what do you think?
LSD.
I think that's a good option. Maybe not everyday escapism, but
well, you literally can't do it every day.
You wouldn't want to. Fucking hell.
Yeah.
It's my friend Tommy.
For me, it would be crocodile.
Are you fucking shitting me?
I mean, it would fucking just start weeding us out a little bit, and like it'd be
sort of the wheat from the chaff.
It'd be, you know, like
really fucking sort it out.
I'm not really one for population control, but it would be a reasonable way of controlling the population.
Darwin's drug. All right, fine.
We're going down there. Bath salts.
Empty, mate. It'd be the ultimate replacement for alcohol. I'm sorry, it would be. Sensibly speaking, MDMA would be the best.
Oh, because, so, like...
Well, wasn't the MDMA... It was invented by the Germans to give to their pilots or something.
No. Many, many of our armed forces have used amphetamines at some point.
To
control...
The dude who developed... So, MDMA wasn't... It wasn't that early. When it was kind of in its early stages of development, the dude who was developing it, he's also developing.
What's his name? I know his name.
I've done reading and I retain nothing, but I remember the story. He was developing MDMA as something that could replace, like you could do a small amount of MDMA and that would replace like a glass or two of champagne. As a social lubricant, because you know it does the same thing of reducing
anxiety, inhibitions, sense of euphoria,
and in small amounts, it doesn't really have a big effect the next day.
Yeah.
So yeah,
my friend told me that he really doesn't have it.
No, because a boss of mine was telling me there's a book, and it was basically how during World War II, the German population were basically given.
Oh, there was a lot of it.
Yeah, state medication. State medication, which basically
it wasn't just the Germans, but yeah.
Well, yeah. Well, no, but it was this book about this whole thing about what they were given, and how it basically turned them all into sort of single focused robots.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah.
Listen to the Tom Waits song, Hell Broke Loose. He has several lyrics in there that refers to the fact that American, English, and German troops were given amphetamines at some point to get through PTSD.
Yeah.
And now modern science is catching up and going, maybe we should treat PTSD with amphetamines.
Yeah. Never mind.
Yeah. Anyway.
Yeah. I mean, it's a reasonable use of it. Absolutely.
Anyway, let's have a light-hearted topic. Come on.
Cool. Would you care to grab one, Tom, from...
No, I just got the last one.
Okay, Tom, then.
Why is it me again?
Yeah, I got the last one.
This one. Is it going to be another element?
How long we got? 15 minutes, roughly?
About five.
One more, then.
From John again.
All right, emo kid.
What is the most... degrading thing you have ever done for money?
Oh, okay. You said for money. I was about to say this podcast. I have done a stuntman shot for money.
A stuntman shot?
Yeah.
Describe?
What? In...
You snort? Okay, so it's basically a tequila slammer.
Yes. Yeah.
Tequila slammer. You snort the salt, you drink the booze, and you stick the lime in your eye.
Mm.
Yeah. LAN gaming.
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Got to say LAN gaming.
I've never particularly done anything...
I did that for 20 quid. I think I got 20 quid out of that.
Oh, actually, do you know what? The most degrading thing I've ever done for money, which is something I did and paid money in order to do it, was
That's opposite, but okay.
No, because like it still works.
Gildando.
There was a point where I was a previous girlfriend I was sleeping with. We were banging away,
so.
And at some point she pulled away and she said, "Okay, I'm done." I was like, "Well, I'm not." And she just said, "Well, all right, you can carry on for a fiver." So he's like, "I went yes."
Jesus.
And then, like, I finished off and then gave her a fiver, and then I felt immediately dirty and had her laugh at me.
That's bad. That is bad.
Like, fucking...
Props to her. Absolute props to her. Like, that is absolutely the most boss thing to do ever, but
it kind of solidified the idea, like the thought I'd had, that I was never really into the idea of like attempting prostitute, like going in, like trying prostitution.
Yeah.
But I think that's like, yeah, I think that's it for me. What about you, Dom?
Never done anything for money.
See, I've done a lot of things for money. I've done a lot of stupid things for money. I can't really think of any, though. I've definitely, like, run across, like, fire, like, bonfires and things like that for money. I've definitely outdrunk people for money.
Yeah.
I once outdrunk a 17-year-old girl for money. That was at the 192-hour house party, motherfucker.
Boom!
Okay, so,
I mean, you've been in theatre long enough. Have you never had to appear on stage in a really stupid costume for the extra costume pay?
I've dressed as a monk, and I've dressed as, like, a Victorian pub worker, but that's it. I've never worn really stupid costumes.
Right.
This is, yeah. The most stupidest thing I've done is where I went to boarding school was also a activity place, and my brain being my brain, I managed to get us into the room where all the keys were kept for everything on this site.
And then we tried to joyride quad bikes. In the middle, in the middle of the night, all completely hammered. And then we stole the school minibus. So,
was any of that humiliating? Were you riding the quad bike naked?
No.
Well,
lived a very sheltered life. My sister's the one. Sister's the wild one. I'm the quiet one.
Fair dues.
You know my sister. You know.
Yeah, we know your sister.
Well, I mean, to be fair, it follows. I'm also like, you're the youngest, aren't you?
Middle child.
Are you? I
am a middle child.
You're the middle child.
Yes.
So is your brother the youngest?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Oh.
Endurers have no idea what you're talking about.
No, none whatsoever. No, I mean, so the middle child in my family is off the fucking hook.
No, you're the baby.
I am the baby.
Freya's the middle child.
Yeah, she is.
Yeah, I love Freya.
Everyone loves Freya.
Hell yeah.
She's an absurd beast of absurdity.
Beast is a strong word. Devil would be more that.
Cool. Let's call it there, Tom.
Fuck yeah. Okay.
Dom, what you got to plug?
Me.
Yeah,
Sneak Dante, Instagram. Want stuff made, email me.
Okay, so what's your Instagram?
Sneak Dante.
Cool.
That's it.
What's your Facebook?
Sneak Dante Stealth Inferno. Actually,
what's I do have a Facebook. Your Twitter?
I don't have one.
What's your Tumblr?
Inferno?
Dirty porno yes, bitch.
I'm stuck with that.
Oh.
Taron, what you got?
I have a book out. You can find it on Amazon Kindle. Just go to Amazon, do a search for Walking Out by Taron Wilmore. You can find my Facebook page at facebook.com/Taron Wilmore Books. That's TARANWILMORE Books. And you know what? There's been an update.
Are you fucking shitting me?
That's the album.
I'm looking this up right now. What the fuck?
I'm basically talking about the bits.
Facebook.com/
I'm basically talking about the bit that I wrote and we recorded for Seventh Dimension's new album. But it's up there. And
it's loading. I don't believe
it. I did an update.
It's loading. It's still loading.
Go check that out. And if you're willing to go check that out, follow up by going and checking out. By checking out Tom's plug.
So my plug tonight, you may not have been able to guess it. To be fair, I'm still trying to look up your plug. Anyway,
it's Tom's plug tonight. It's full of Swedes, and he's feeling it's right. Seventh Dimension.
Go to seventh-dimension.net/store and buy the fuck out of Rikard's new album.
Or you know, facebook.com/seventh-dimension-band. They've got everything you need on there.
Also, you can find it. It's called The Corrupted Lullaby. It's on iTunes, on Spotify, on all your streaming platforms. But please, go and buy a physical copy.
Yeah, and also, if you go via Taron Wilmore Books, you can find, like, the write-out of mine and Tom's contribution to the album, which is in the first minute of the first song of the first disc. Oh! I'm we're officially Swedish prog rock stars.
Okay, I'm looking at your Facebook page right now, and it says, "Why, hello there, it's the 24th of December, 2015.
It's on there, mate.
Looking at it right now, bruv.
I mean, I've still got the video pegged. It doesn't matter.
Cue the music! Share and tell a friend. That's the only way we're going to get more listeners. The website is podtopicpodcast.com. No, not never happening ever again. Go there to submit the topic.
You can look at me as much as you
find
want.
Out various links and shit. Search Pot Topic Podcast on all your social medias and find us.
including Anchor.
Send your emails, and can we have some audio topics? We haven't had an audio topic in a fucking while.
God, that'd be fucking lovely. Yeah, send that to pothoppingpodcast.com. Emails at pothoppingpodcast.com.
That's the one. And we will definitely play it on there. So no matter how grotesque. So like, you can literally tell us, like, Babadookie, eat a dick. Done. We will play it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Rate and review on iTunes and Stitcher. What do we think for this one?
Oh, mate, it's always three.
Three?
Always
three and
three.
A half. I'm going to be positive. Three and a half.
Can you do half stars?
No.
Three Boshdies to one.
Link up with your friend. Get your friend to submit four stars. You submit three. And then we'll get somewhere in the middle. And of course, like the video on YouTube. Bullshit. And of course, thank you all the endurers for enduring this evening. And of course, thank you all the hosts for joining this evening. Taryn.
Oh,
Monkey Fist.
That was me. Okay, then.
Orangafruüp.
I mean, I would.
Umlaut. Three piece.
I would like to pass over a massive thanks to Orangafruüp for 2 U's and Umlaut.
Umlaut!
For the use of their songs, Trippples with 3 P's.
3 P's!
You can find Trippples with 3 P's on the self-titled album, Orangafruüp with 2 U's and Umlaut. You can find that shit on Bandcamp and Spotify and shit. Just go have a look. Buy it. Buy. They deserve your money.
10 quid, mate. Trippples is wicked. On Wobbly Records.
Oh, you're hearing it right now. It's good.
Yeah. So, with that, Taryn.
Kalababoshi!
Oh, wait. You next time.
I've just filled my glass, sir.
That's next time. Let's have some scotch.
Let's have some scotch.
Neck it.
Boshi. Is it Boshi? Hey, really? Jordan was here, Boshi, as well.
Boshi?
He says the Boshi. We've got a 3A Boshi going on here.
Good next scotch.
I think.
Hit the scotch.
I think the only reasonable thing to do now is to finish this off with a nice hearty
Bosh D.
Come back!
I think I just had a salad.
I've got a timer ready to go.
Sweet. I think we've probably got enough silence somewhere.
Is that your phone buzzing, Dom?
Yeah.
Is it so good that it's picking up signal even though it's on airplane mode?
Yes.
Yes. Let's go with that, eh? What you reading there, Dom?
What am I reading?
Yeah.
Big book of useless information ever.
Cool. Is that your bit for this show? You're just going to sit there and read it, and occasionally go, did you know?
Did you know?
Did you know?
Wait, we're going to have content.
Fine content.
No, so I thought as you burn through the little book of riders,
yeah,
going to start bringing in useless facts.
Absolutely. What this podcast needs is more tripe.
Yeah.
No, absolutely. No, definitely. Good idea. I can't remember what I did with my vape, to be fair.
You gave it to Kimmy, I believe.
Yeah, maybe. Fuck knows. She probably lost it already.
Ooh.
Racist.
Cultural appropriation, I think, there.
Not even her culture, just straight up racist.
It has nothing to do with her. It was just, I realized
they don't make that sound in Beckton.
No, it's like, oh, it sounds similar to those wood clacks, doesn't it? And then it reminded me of Naruto. Shut up. Go fuck yourself.
Racist!
What, that?
No, never mind. Is that the intro?
No.
All right, let's do another clap then. Go on then.
Police in Germany had to rescue a swimming pool attendant at a hen party after the bride-to-be tried to bully him into having sex. Oh, a Romanian father of five needed medical help after he superglued a condom onto his penis.
It's almost like my experience, to be fair.
Oh, it's inflating like a balloon!
It's the fact it was almost Halloween, so I could have just thrown it out the on the road with trick-or-treaters.
Two San Francisco police officers have been caught moonlighting in a hardcore porn movie.
Straight or...
I don't know.
Probably not.